Subjects in my mind running wild, images of a parallel life. You don't even have a clue of all the things I'm doing to you. What's wrong in reality? G'day everybody, and welcome. Thanks for listening. Welcome to Match Fit with Davo and J-Man, the first ever episode one. It is ASRNZ affiliated podcast, and I'll just take this chance to introduce the other half, the better half of this podcast here, the J-Man. Good mate and ever faithful wingman, welcome to episode one of Match Fit, J-Man.
Jesus, Davo, it's a bloody pleasure to be here. Thank you for that introduction. You're better half, something like that. I'm definitely a half, some might say others, but yeah, mate, Jesus, it's good to get this thing going. You know, it's been a long time coming for you and I, this, but yeah. Looking forward to this.
Yes, it has been a long time coming, but it sort of seems natural evolution from, you know, like our past exploits. And I suppose people are probably listening already a minute or so in, or a few seconds in, and just thinking, why, how, where did this come from? Why not? We've sort of wondered why ourselves, but then, yes, like you said, J-Man, why not? I think we just needed something a little bit more from than what we were able to give in our regular Thursday night commentary on at ASRNZ as we follow their series around.
Totally, Davo.
Yeah, so, yeah, we just thought that, you know, this might give us a chance to just have a bit of a casual chat away from the official racing, just about general online stuff, online racing, mods, cars, different platforms, whatnot, and obviously give us a chance, I suppose, to get a little bit more in depth and a bit more of a technical look at and breakdown of, you know, the racing that's going on at ASO at the moment.
And the globe, and in the real world too.
Absolutely. For that matter too, Davo. Absolutely. So there you go. That's the why, and I suppose the how we sort of came to this moment. But
And so it'd be here nice, we are. Maybe for I guess in this inaugural one, Davo, you know, to sort of give a little bit of an insight, obviously. You know, those that may tune in, obviously fully aware of the media stuff we do on a Thursday night now around the streams and stuff, but in relation to where did it all come from? And, you know, you mentioned, you know, great mates as we are, and there's a fair bit of history, but, you know, like, you know, we go back a fair old way. So, you know, I guess if we were to, start that off.
I suppose we should just give a little bit of a history lesson, you know, like we've been personal friends for quite a few years, but it started way back probably in about 2010 years ago or so. You know, like after, I suppose we both started really getting into some online PC racing, and after, I don't know about yourself, J-Man, but I cut my teeth with my online stuff with the Gran Turismo, as I know a lot of boys did. Started on the consoles and sort of progressed to PC stuff, and no doubt yourself, yeah?
So not so much for, I guess that inception was around that for online was, yeah, probably goes back a little bit further. You probably robbed us of a couple of years there, bro, but it was probably 07, 08, something like that, and it was R Factor 1 for, I guess a true online experience prior to that. You know, I go back with guys like Steve-O, Belling, who, you know, one of our founding members here at ASRNZ, that, you know, we obviously go a lot further back, but it was more land play than online. You know, we were probably a little bit later to the piece than some of you guys that did some of the Gran Turismo and early NASCAR stuff. So,
I mean, look, I played, you know, sim games right through from a long time before 2010, but yeah, just the online experience really started for me 10 years ago, and it was a bit of a change because the commitment that goes into online racing when you do it, working with PCs, it's epic, and now my office is just full of rig and computers. So
100%. So that said, you know, this you know, we won't weekly go into a history lesson, but I think it'd be nice to cover this off for some of the guys that haven't been around as long. And, you know, this is the pit lane. We will be match fit as best we can.
Hence the name.
Yep.
It is a Sunday afternoon, of course.
So if we were to go back that far, Davo, you know, adrenaline factor.
Well, that's a good start, because that's where we actually met, you know, in an online community. Let's go back to, and actually we'll bring up a little bit of old footage here.
Nice.
Let's bring up a bit of ADN stuff there. You got that,
Jamie?
ADN was our... Well, obviously my natural progression from Gran Turismo into PC, and this was a good place to land for me. These boys run by, who was it, YZ250?
Yeah.
Yes, yeah. Always ran a very tight ship, YZ250, but the Adrenaline Factor community had something unique, and what they had was an in-house modded V8 supercar. And that made them unique. Drew some
what a
very
mongrel to drive too. Initially,
super tough to drive.
Yeah,
really, really hard stuff to cut your teeth on. But mate, wasn't it awesome?
Mate, it was. It was really, really good. The racing was tough. I can remember gridding up early in the piece with the likes of Steve-O and yourself and Deviator and Grimmy, all these guys.
Mike 80, Kenny Simpson. There's a lot of names there that you still will see today at ASR. So.
Yep. But, you know, I remember turning up at Dubai and there was like 54 cars on the grid. And, you know, to make a top 20 back in those days is... it's probably equally as hard as what it is to make a top 10 now at ASRNZ. So,
absolutely.
Yeah, that was a cool time, and you know, we sort of hung out there for a fair whack, and some good championships being run there. And certainly for me personally, that was probably the start of going over and you know, we're actually catching up with some of these guys. In reality, I can, you know, can quote Garner, Queensland Raceway, to watch the supercars and catching up with X-W383, Craig Nofke, and then catching up with yourself as well. So that, you know, that's probably the start of something pretty cool there.
Of a very cool friendship, and which has, again, brought us back to where we are today. But, yeah, so with some of this footage, you can see how difficult these cars were to drive at some stages throughout the season here at Bathurst. This is a bit of a promo video for a Bathurst round. Lots of names out there, but yeah, awesome stuff. Really enjoyed our time at Adrenaline Factor, but as things wound down over at Adrenaline Factor, and we were, gentlemen, for a better word, whoring around a little bit. We always liked to get around.
There was a bit of that.
We used to get around to quite a few communities and do a little bit of racing here and there. It was just sort of one thing led to another, and I suppose that's where we sort of ended up at a place called Hardcore Online Gaming. J-Man, you got that one?
Yeah, mate, I've got that one there. Yeah, you had to be there. You certainly had to be there.
Now, really, oh, God, this hardcore... there's sort of no prisoners racing at Hardcore. Oh, fantastic group of guys. Definitely don't suffer, you know, whinges and, you know.
No, they'll certainly tell it how it is.
And Rubbing was racing and, you know, very fair on track, but definitely take no prisoners stuff. And, mate, I don't know about you, but we fitted right in here.
Yeah, a lot of cool stuff online and some cool memories of some of these boys in real life too, you know, barbecues at your place. And but yeah, the racing was always good, and it was always, it had a different flair to it at Hardcore, you know, and still does to this day. You can go and have a shoot 'em up and then the next day you're out banging panels on track or jumping trophy trucks or Nux and Fieldsy and the team, and you know, all the guys there bring a pretty cool show.
Bring a pretty cool show. And I think, you know, the whole theme of Hardcore really was, you know, the essence of, you know, like the main man, which is Nux, Toby Smith. And, you know, like he's a big personality, and he really made Hardcore what it is.
I've met him, though. He's a soft cop, really.
Yeah. He's a big boy, but he's a soft bloke and a big teddy bear. But yeah, it's super top blokes. Like you said, you mentioned Fieldsy as well.
Yeah.
A lot of big names, actually, if you watch back through some of the old early Hardcore stuff. Again, we've got Kenny Simpson, we've got VL Group A, we've got Bear Grylls, we've got Steve and... Steve Wilton, our farmer, yes. A whole bunch of guys that raced at Hardcore over the years for a long time. Hardcore still going strong. I'm still admin over there at their forum and still race there once a week at least. Still got a lot to do with Hardcore. Something else they brought us, Hardcore, which nobody else was doing, and again, thanks to Nux, was the trophy truck and the off-road stuff. Man, as we see this video, actually, that we've got playing in the background. Next level. It was right up particular, you know, it's a particular type of racing really liked by guys that like, you know, motocross bikes and stuff. So we dirt racing. So we saw the Kenny Simpsons, the Steve Mellings there.
The physics, Dave, you got used to the physics. You got used to the way that they were going to preload and bounce. And
yeah,
there's always a heap of help around these setups on the night with these things. And
the racing was...
Farmer took to these things really well as well, I might add.
Yeah, lots of... Oh, mate. Yeah, I think... And Steve-O didn't do too bad either. He's a bit of a bike head, so... But Farmer definitely... But yeah, just watch some of that footage. Crazy to look at. It was epic racing. Nobody else did it.
Very unique to Hardcore, and you know, and a great part of the personally for me, part of the evolution of you know where I've come from as far as sim racing. You know, like you know, they gave us a home when we were, I guess, in limbo a little bit. You know, because we were sort of, I don't know if we were lost, but we were certainly searching for the next thing to do, and which probably leads us down the road a little bit further.
It does.
And it probably alludes us to a place that it's still got a special spot for me as well, which is JFF.
Okay, let's just get a bit of...
Yeah, just for fun. Always enjoyed my time and... Oh, a great amount of
as we see that is it Scotty? Is it
and Scotty and Maggie? Yeah, so
Scotty and Maggie. As we just see the video fire up there,
nice
with and look, JFF again, very diverse in you know the what they raced at JFF. There's all sorts of stuff. They raced all types of cars. Very very friendly community. Very helpful. Yep. But really, what these guys are famous for is what we're watching here right now, actually, J-Man. And it's the
Peter Brock Memorial.
The Peter Brock Memorial. This has been running for over 10 years. They ran it again just a few weeks ago, I think, before the official Bathurst in real life. This is epic stuff. It is a full 161-lap race in usually the awesome mod. I've competed in it a few times.
As have I.
So have you. This is a tough gig, and kudos to these boys year after year running this. It attracts massive numbers some years.
It does. It does.
Everybody wants to be a part of this. Big grids. And yeah, obviously,
it's a tough one to tick off.
It is a tough one to tick off. And so, you know, you've got big grids of cars, and you also got, you know, like multiple drivers. Some teams will have three drivers, some will have two. So there's a bunch of guys, a lot of organization, full custom skin packs.
Yeah.
And 161 laps of racing. So absolutely epic stuff.
Yeah, that's a massive task. And you know, we've all got a bit older. You know, maybe you know, some have got more talent, some have got less, I don't know, but I remember that one being hard back in the day, and I can only imagine how hard it is now to try and physically do that. We've progressed from a lot of us have progressed from, you know, G25s or, you know, Mad Cat wheels and stuff to some wheels with a little bit more force feedback and you know, a bit more pressure under the middle pedal now. Guys looking for 120 kilo load cells and so forth. Make a race like that start to come a bit grueling. So props to those guys, man. And like I said, you know, props to JWF for having us. And, you know, I can remember just before we break away from this little segment here, watching these guys coming up over top of McPhillamy Park, heading into Skyline.
And
there.
Look at it.
You know, Scotty and the team did give us a nice little handout at the start of the ASRNZ. Not so much ASRNZ, but Assetto Corsa came about not long after we were kicking around here, and they gave us a bit of a handout to try and get that going. It wasn't everybody's forte at the time, you know. No one was really looking that way. So, which I guess leads us down to the next road, Davo.
There's one other community we probably should mention, which is sort of really an integral part of, you know, like, again, how we came to this. And
a visual on that.
Wait, let's just...
Yes, we do.
We've got something on that, yes, and here we go. So, none other than the Online Racing Australasia, or Australia as it was originally known, originally run by a bloke called Quasi, again, a man with a vision, put together a great community of blokes. To be honest, more mature sort of guys. So again, a very, very friendly community, very helpful and super respectful on track.
And look at that. That's synonymous with that name. RRA and the annual 624.
That's right.
Is probably you know if you've ever been a part of that, you'd never forget it.
No, it's a bit of a long story. RRA has since shut down and wound up, but has merged with a few of the boys that have left RRA. Yuli and Co. There's actually quite a big handful of guys that have sort of travelled over to hardcore. And so these races, these 624s and the Monster 500 that they run late in the year, these races still live. These big events still live in slightly different guise, at a different community. But the name, the Online Racing Australasia name, lives on there. And obviously archived at Papa Osa Productions. A lot of racing from ORA, and yes, as I'll just quickly mention, they were another that stepped up and wanted to have a look at what we're going to get to, and that is it was the ASRNZ, and it was the Assetto Corsa, and nobody really wanted to go near the Assetto Corsa.
Real strange time too. I mean, we get very, you know what I mean? I mean, to this point, as we move down to this Assetto Corsa era, this period, because it certainly wasn't an era.
I'll just click on that video just quickly, J-Man, so you can watch what we're watching there. I think it's a little bit of footage from Grubnik very early on in the ASRNZ days, if you can get that up.
Yeah. Great track to grub. BMW... M3s with a flavour, I think, and 190E Mercedes, I think, were also a good go-to.
Yes.
But, yeah, no, so a funny time because, you know, we probably still, you know, if you look around the sim traps at the moment, you know, there's still your staunch iRacing guys, your staunch R-Factor 2 guys.
Absolutely.
I guess your ACCC guys, probably the wider community, from my perspective, from what I saw, didn't go down that route, you know. Hence why, back in the day, we were at this point around 2015, and after a little bit of support from these guys at ORA and JWF and Hardcore as well.
And a little bit from Hardcore as well, absolutely.
Fieldsy was sort of setting a few things up as well at the back there and trying to have a go. And
But what we struggled with, didn't we, J-Man, was just to try and get that momentum going. You know, like it was okay that we were getting a little bit of, a little bit of talk from the, because these are, I mean, at the end of the day, they're traditionally R-Factor communities that we were racing at. And so this was the new kid on the block. It was pretty, it looked fantastic. Pretty. Everybody wanted to have a look at it. There's always, there always is, there's the bitch about the physics and the tyre models and blah, 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 but it looked pretty.
And it was pretty buggy at best too.
In the early days, it was.
We went through that beta period.
And it was just hard to get some momentum out of these R-Factor communities to actually get something that looked or resembled a series or some sort of league racing or racing really at all. Get some momentum on that. So
that kind of brought us up to 2015, didn't it, Dave?
That's where we get to ASRNZ. And that's why we're here. And that was the end goal, wasn't it, mate? And it was, I suppose, it would have been great to have, I suppose, Steve Melling here today, but we might get him in next week. But
So they're currently, sorry, boys, I will apologise, because as I look down on in my data, the boys are having an admin meeting as we speak, and I'm supposed to be there. But I'm sure there's some really good heads in that room at the moment as I look down there.
Of course,
members will be making some pretty tough decisions and steering this thing. And it's we're 5.5. We're heading into toward our sixth year ASRNZ. So around about the 14th of February, 2015. We were into it. We were a bit earlier, but
it was a little bit earlier. But it was just that core group of guys. It must have been what half a dozen. I suppose
the story goes, Andre said to us, we can do this, and we were like, really? Yeah, let's have a go. Me, Steve-O, and Andre sort of tried to get a server going, and then historically, Bear, yourself, Farmer, all started wandering over, and then we had that early support with Fieldsy and a few of the other guys that of where we came from, and then the growth has steadily just, it's not rapid, but it's been solid to where we're at.
It definitely has, and like those days, and we were just watching the little bit of footage from Grubnik there. I mean, the early days, it was like Andre Billington was able to give us these, like a slot for a race server. And he created a small, simple forum for us to sort of grow some sort of community and all meet and talk about what we wanted to do. It's very, very simple times, and it didn't take long, J-Man. Look, I remember when it was 8, 10, maybe 12 guys on track at the inception, and if we just look at this bit of footage now, if you just want to roll that.
So this is still in the Assetto Corsa, not the Competizione days we are now, but this is the AC days when we were, I guess, skinning cars. And what are we looking at, GT3s? We are, aren't we?
We are looking at a year in review from 2017. So this is a couple of years down the track, and the grids were getting big. The racing was hot. We had a full custom skin pack. We were racing all types of car throughout the year. If you can see some of the footage there, J-Man,
I'm with you there, and just watching. I think this was a one make series that the boys did, that just went through there. We've got MX-5s, we've got Porsche. We did kind of left Wednesday nights out for a one make, so we did things like AE86s
and BMWs,
131 Beamers, and Porsche 911 cup cars and
all sorts of stuff. I think we even raced a little bit of open wheel stuff there too.
Yeah, definitely a bit of open wheel stuff.
So as we, I mean, obviously we were new and still growing, and it was, you know, we were just AC, which is obviously different to ACC, which is a dedicated GT3 mod. There was mods aplenty, and you know, we were exploring everything for racing, and it was awesome. And look how.
Look at some of
the footage from back then. Oh, it's awesome. All sorts of cars, some big grids.
And a lot of learnings going on during this process too, you know, Dave. You know, we were doing things like the inception of PLP. You know, we got some great guys in this community. Aztec being one of them helped us introduce that system there, where we had marker app that basically, you know, a perimeter app that actually overrode the game and said that, you know, you've got to drive within this perimeter here, otherwise you will get a penalty, you know, five cuts and you're going to do a drive through. And there was a lot of learnings, and there's always learnings. But man, look at that grid. Look at the grid.
It was fantastic, didn't it? Grow so quickly. All custom skin. It was epic. And and I suppose
beamers and,
as the popularity grew, and obviously as our sort of social media presence grew, you know, like they just kept coming, and they just kept coming, and the fields ended up just massive. It wasn't very long before we ended up having to cap the bloody grid.
31 or 32 or something, yeah.
So and it happened so quickly. It was such a snowball effect, and it was a testament, I suppose, to the admin and always going back after the year had finished and rethinking it and looking at it again, and always sort of had growth, you know, as, you know, for the next year in mind, and, you know, what was going to be different, what was going to be next. And it just showed by the, you know, like the ultimate growth in the community, and we're still clearly running strong today as we run with the ACC stuff. But
that shift come at January of 2020. The community effectively shifted over to that ACC platform, Davo, and which was originally just a GT3, and then we got the GT4. So which I guess brings us to almost where we're at now. We're a season in. We're a season into these GT4s, and
after a couple of GT3 seasons already, and this year. So it's good, and the year. I think the GT4s coming was coming on board with the GT4s was a good thing. It definitely mixed it up. The cars are way different to drive than the GT3 cars, and it's good to see the boys either reveling or struggling. You know,
it's a hell of a spectacle.
It is.
On a Thursday. I guess the history lessons basically brought us up to where we're at, which is, you know, that's you know, there's a lot obviously in between there, and we can't go into massive detail. I don't want to go too much into there, but that's brought us up to here and to where we are. And you know, these boys are peddling these GT4s at the moment, and they're all doing a great job. And I should have probably looked at the stats, Davo, but currently, you know, this these fields are, you know, mid-20s is pretty standard now. So, you know, we spoke about capping those fields, so we're at about mid-20s at the moment, heading towards a silly season too, I might add.
Yeah, I suppose, and again, it's just, you know, we always analyse these numbers, and as obviously commentators, you know, we've sort of always got numbers and, you know, times and strategies in our heads. But you know, like I think at the moment, you know, we got that peak where we were actually, you know, basically just closing the door and saying, no, look, we can't afford, the server wouldn't basically handle any more people.
Yeah.
Now we have, you know, like at the moment, the group of guys that are racing here, most of them are turning up every week. It's not just, you know, the here and there sort of stuff anymore.
And it's ripping hot, man. Like it's just, you know, like obviously you just during that that Bathurst Enduro the other, you know, past week on the Thursday. And man, if you can pick, not just your winner but your top five, man, that's crystal bullshit.
It is.
Just,
it is. As I'll just
not gonna.
No, well, that's right. You know, like, it's so difficult, and you know, we always put our little spin on it. Yeah. On the night, but I'll just play this last little bit of video we've got here. Actually, this is our last ever skin pack video.
This is
from a few years ago. And you will see.
Look at the musical cars at the famous photo shoot at the start of the season.
We're talking big grids, mate. You look at the amount of cars we see get lined up here for a bit of a photo shoot before the start of the
shakedown shoots. Ain't they?
Yeah.
As I said, I just seen the Peposa Production logo down there. Jeez, we've got to pay a bit of homage to all of this stuff, to Peposa Productions, which is a branch out of your playbook there, Davo. So
It is. Thank you very much.
Thousands of hours of archive footage through all of these communities that we've just spoke of.
All of them and more. We've really only just touched the surface. So, absolutely. Look.
So these are the shakedown photo shoots. So the idea was every season we'd have the shakedown round. We'd do a photo shoot. These things could take up to 25 minutes.
Yeah, well, just looking at the parking, some of these guys race really well, but I don't know about their parking skills, J-Man, to be honest.
I'm not sure I'd let them take my car to the supermarket, mate, really.
It was always a good, fun night, and it was just, I suppose, at the end of the day, and this is a testament to the administration again, you know, like, it was a shakedown for these massive custom skin packs that we used to run, where, you know, there was 30-odd cars, there was 30-odd skin packs, you know, like multiple teams, and it was just a chance for it to get them all on the grid, get them all in the server, and make sure everything was running before we'd kick off the next week. And it was always good fun and a bit of a laugh, but there you go. Look at that grid, J-Man.
Massive.
Fantastic. Always, massive. And always a bit of fun at the end there, obviously.
So that gives us an insight into that, and I guess, you know, looking at that, you know, that shapes where it ended up at now with what we're doing. You know, so obviously we've gone through that whole process. You and I have decided that, you know, we do this thing on a Thursday night, and then it'd be nice just to have a little bit of an analyse on just what goes down on that night. Because, you know, we tend to be pretty spent at the end of it.
Yes.
The thing for, you know, a couple of hours and then...
Yeah, well, sometimes up to 2.5 hours, we're pretty well flat chat with very short breaks in between. But
So I think it's probably a nice chance to sort of reflect, and then, like you said, we can go through some things and sort of see what's going on. So, you know, we'll chalk this one up to a bit, you know, obviously to letting everybody know what's going on. But I still can't help but think, even now with heading to this point here, Davo, you know, like, you know, where are we at? Now, 2020, basically the start of a new month. We've got what do we got? Three more rounds of this 2020 GT4 Championship left to go.
Yes. As the year winds down,
no surprises that we've got guys like John McDonald, JB, and the Breakfast Crew Racing BMW at the top of this championship with a massive lead. Like, he's, you know, I think he's got, I may have seen the 14 or 15 point buffer over Luke Crompton. We got guys at the minute like Craig Stoneley. You know, if we were podcasting this time 6 months ago, even 3 months ago, we hadn't even heard of this name, and this guy comes out and wins one of the biggest enduros we've got in the calendar year.
And it looked from the comms box like he did it with ease too, J-Man, to be honest.
I've had a quick peek at that Mazzano already on the lap stats, and I tell you what, he looks every bit as fast going into this next round as he did last week.
That's good to hear. I haven't been able to catch up with it yet, but you know what that confidence can breed, you know, like in a man, you know, when they go out for the next round, and especially such a big race, like you mentioned, with some pretty serious competition. I mean, he was chased down by Coppo the whole race. Josh Vettiger in the background. I think it was with John McDonald.
Yep.
Like, these guys are some serious contenders. It was an interesting race, but he will take that confidence into the next round without a doubt.
Yeah, and there was, you know, it wasn't, you know, like, it wasn't, you know, no enduros without a little bit of, I don't know, a controversy or certainly upset, but certainly I think the two BMW shocked the field to be able to pull that one off with a nose stopper. But, you know, we saw what was involved. You know, we called it straight away. We saw them going up mountain straight on the outlet in fourth gear, low throttle percentages, you know.
Yeah, no weaving, no nothing.
No nothing. We talked to them and they had to drive to a number. I think John said he came across with 0.8 of a litre, so even 1 litre in the tank.
Yeah.
And given that it takes somewhere around the 2.5 to 3.5 litres to do a lap, if they had to go one more, he's effectively James.
Game over. No, definitely a big risk. And this is the sort of stuff we think that is valuable, you know, obviously to the ASRNZ community. Just a little bit more of a debrief, obviously, on the week's racing. And just sort of, I suppose, keeping in touch with what we're looking at during the week. We, you know, in constant contact through the week. And I just think that we've got a little bit more to give, haven't we, J-Man?
Yeah. And I mean, you know, I think we do. I think there's going to be some stuff that we bring up and you might like to swipe right or whatever, but certainly some of the subjects might be appealing to you, and we'll try and cover some of them off. And, you know, even if there's something that the viewers want us to look into, you know, flick us a message during the week, give us your thoughts, and we'll give you our insights on what we think about it. But, you know, in relation to that, you know, like the guys are sitting at the moment as we speak, that, you know, the 3 rounds to go, Davo, they're obviously already talking about What happens after Christmas, or what happens during Christmas, or after Christmas?
Yep, that's right.
What's your take, mate? Where did you personally want to see things going?
Look, I'd probably don't need
Someone
to tell you. you know it, and I don't need to tell you because you already know where my alliances lies. I like low group racing. I like cars that feel like they've got no brakes and very little rubber and basically zero aero. I really enjoy the GT4s. If we could drive something older, I'd be all over it. I think that would be perfect for this community. Unfortunately, it's not in ACC. I doubt we'll ever go back to it. So,
you don't think we'd look back at AC for a series at all?
I'd hope so. I'd hope so. Oh, I think there's always room for one-off fun series in between the main game, you know, like the GT3 or the GT4 series. But my alliances really lie with this current GT4 mod. I think it's great to watch. It really tests the boys. I love the format. It just ticks all the boxes. Take a bit of wing off these cars, take a bit of rubber off these cars, and give them some less brakes. And we see it week in, week out, J-Man. It's awesome to watch. So that's what I'd like to see. I'd like to see more GT4s in 2021.
Yeah, I'm going to have to agree with you. I think it's definitely it's got a place. I'm not saying that GT3s don't. I think there's a lot of history, and there's a lot of history in ASRNZ in the Hall of Fame as well. You know, like there's some prestigious championships being won and contested in there. I'm sure guys would like to have another go at being able to tick those ones off. And certainly not everybody's going to respond to a smaller tyre and less wing. Some guys like the technical stuff. So I get it. And over the coming weeks, when we get this thing a little bit more fine-tuned, we will come to you with a new email. It will be a match fit or a pit lane email that will basically give the opportunity to post in some questions and ask us some things that you want. You know, if there's something you want to see, something you want to talk about.
Absolutely.
It's all material for us, and you know, this is two blokes that basically have stemmed this out of just wanting to carry on I guess the Thursday. You know, we have a practice session on a Tuesday, we have a race night on a Thursday, And Dave and myself, you know, we live and breathe this stuff, and we want to play on, and we want to, you know, discuss it a bit further.
We've got more. We've definitely got more people. So, yes, you well said, mate. And definitely, look, listeners, whoever's watching this first episode of Match Fit, just look, give us your feedback, get involved, you know, comment, suggest future conversations or content or something you'd like to see, if you think we should be touching base on stuff, or even if we shouldn't be touching base on certain things.
Yeah, at the end of the day, let us know. I mean,
absolutely.
We've got control of the button, so we'll decipher whether you hear it or not.
Yeah.
And we'd like to go through some, you know, real life content as well. You know, there's a
for
whole
sure.
factor of stuff that's going to feature in there. And, you know, I might like to even segment that. You know, there'll be segments. There'll be driver profile segments. I'd like to touch base on, as we are now, you know, Scotty McLaughlin for tying up his third consecutive title at DJR Tim Penske.
That's right. Do you think we could get him in as a guest speaker, J-Man?
Oh, I know you're
friendly with him.
Yeah, we could maybe ask him and see how he's going. He's currently obviously shifted offshore
off to the States
to drive an Indy car. So props to Scotty.
And
all the best for him there. And
Definitely. But you like you just. Getting at is there's so much to talk about. You know, there's you know, stuff going on at DJR, Scotty and you know, the boys moving forward in their careers. We've got, you know, the V8 supercars, you know, slowly eroding away in front of us as we watch our social media over the last couple of weeks. We probably need to pull it up now, I think.
But before we do, I just want to touch on one last thing.
Let's go.
How's your rugby team, mate?
How's my rugby team? Oh, did I miss that? Did I miss something last night?
I don't think you missed much, mate. We'll leave it at that.
Okay, thanks, mate.
We'll leave it at that.
I appreciate that. So.
Big props to yourself. I'm going to just give you a little plug here, Davo, because I know how much work's gone into this, and this thing will only get better. So I commend you on your efforts to this point and getting this thing off the ground, and really do appreciate and shout out to Aztec for all the technical stuff that he's done in the back.
Yes, definitely. Thanks, Aztec.
And also with me when it comes to the Thursday night stuff, I think it's really nice to acknowledge Aztec and what he does for us and for ASRNZ and in fact all of those guys, you know. But
absolutely.
So, on a parting note, Davo, really, really cool to get this thing going off.
Yes, definitely.
I'm sure we'll have a playback, mate, and come back at it next week bigger and better. We've got
so much more to say, and we've already in probably 40 odd minutes, but we have still got so much to say. Look, if it goes a week, I'd be surprised, but you'll definitely see us next week for episode 2. Thank you, viewers.
Yep,
whoever's
thank
watching,
much.
Thank you, listeners. Whoever's watching and listening, thanks for joining the ASRNZ Match Fit with Davo and the J-Man Episode 1 official podcast. Get involved. Follow us on our socials. Click on the buttons. Give us some feedback. We will be back. Thank you very much. Thanks, J-Man.
See you guys.
Talk soon. Bye.